Hi, welcome to introduction video about the Angular framework. In this video, we're gonna explain what Angular is, why you should use it, and give some brief overview of its features. But before we start, make sure to check my channel for more videos and tutorials about front-end development. Now, let's start. Angular is an opinionated UI framework for building mobile and desktop applications. And it's built using TypeScript by Google. You probably heard about that one. Also, it is an open source and helps us build dynamic and single-page applications. It is completely based on components. It consists of several components which forms a tree structure with parent and child components. Angular's versions beyond 2+ are generally known as Angular only. The very first version of Angular is known as AngularJS. So, why Angular? Well, because it's supported on various platforms, web, mobile, desktop, native. It's powerful, modern, has nice ecosystem, and it's just cool. Not convinced? Let me give you some facts. Angular presents you not only the tools, but also design patterns to build your project in a maintainable way. When an Angular application is crafted properly, you don't end up with a tangle of classes and methods that are hard to modify and even harder to test. The code is structured conveniently, and you won't need to spend much time in order to understand what is going on. It's JavaScript, but better. Angular is built with TypeScript, which in turn relies on JS ES6. You don't need to learn a totally new language, but you still receive features like static typing, interfaces, classes, namespaces, decorators, etc. No need to reinvent the bicycle. With Angular, you already have lots of tools to start crafting the application right away. You have directives to give HTML elements dynamic behavior. You can power up the forms using form control and introduce various validation rules. You may easily send asynchronous HTTP requests of various types. You can set up routing with little hassle. And there are many more goodies that Angular can offer us. Components are decoupled. Angular strives to remove the tight coupling between various components of the application. Injection happens in Node.js style, and you may replace various components with ease. All DOM manipulation happens where it should happen. With Angular, you don't tightly couple presentation and application logic, making your markup much cleaner and simpler. Testing is at the heart. Angular is meant to be thoroughly tested, and it supports both unit and end-to-end testing. Angular is mobile and desktop ready, meaning you have one framework for multiple platforms. Angular is actively maintained and has a large community and ecosystem. You can find lots of materials on this framework as well as many useful third-party tools. The architecture diagram identifies the 8 main building blocks of an Angular application. Angular apps are modular, and an Angular has its own modularity system called Angular modules or NG modules. Every Angular app has at least one Angular module class, the root module, conveniently named app module. While the root module may be the only module in a small application, most apps have many more feature modules, each a cohesive block of code dedicated to an application domain, a workflow, or a closely related set of capabilities. An Angular module, whether a root or a feature, is a class with an ng module decorator. Angular templates are dynamic. When Angular renders them, it transforms the DOM according to the instructions given by directives. Metadata tells Angular how to process a class. Service is a broad category encompassing any value, function, or feature that your application needs. Almost anything can be a service. A service is typical a class with a narrow, well-defined purpose. It should do something specific and do it well. Examples include logging service, data service, message bus, tax calculator, application configuration. There is nothing specifically about Angular services. Angular has no definition of a service. There is no service-based class and no place to register a service. Yet, services are fundamental to any Angular application. Components are big consumers of services. Now, let's talk in detail about components, templates, and dependency injection. Components. Components are the building blocks that compose an application. A component includes a TypeScript class with a component decorator, an HTML template, and styles. The component decorator specifies the following Angular-specific information: a CSS selector that defines how the component is used in a template, HTML elements in your template that match the selector become instances of the component, an HTML template that instructs Angular how to render the component, an optional set of CSS styles that define the appearance of the template's HTML elements. You can see an example of minimal Angular component. To use this component, you write the following in a template. When Angular renders this component, you can see your first Hello World application. Component also make your application easier to test and can improve the overall readability of your code as it breaks down the complexity. Now, templates. Every component has an HTML template that declares how the component renders. You define this template either inline or by file path. Angular extends HTML with additional syntax that lets you insert dynamic values from your component. Angular automatically updates the render DOM when your component state changes. One application of this feature is inserting dynamic text, as shown in the following example. The value for message comes from the component class. When the application loads the component and its template, the user sees the following. Notice the use of double curly braces. They instruct Angular to interpolate the contents within them. Angular also supports property bindings to help you set values for properties and attributes of HTML elements and pass values to your application's presentation logic. Let's add a couple of properties. Now, we can use them in our template. Notice the use of the square brackets. That syntax indicates that you're binding the property or attribute to a value in the component class. You can also declare event listeners to listen for and respond to user action, such as keystrokes, mouse movements, clicks, and touches. You declare event listener by specifying the event name in the parentheses. This button calls a method which we need to define in the components class. Dependency injection. Dependency injection allows you to declare the dependencies of your TypeScript classes without taking care of their instantiation. Instead, Angular handles that for you. Even though understanding dependency injection is not critical to start using Angular, I strongly recommend it as a best practice, and many aspects of Angular take advantage of it to some degree. To illustrate how dependency injection works, consider the following example. The first file, logger-service-ts, defines a logger class. This class contains a writeCount function that logs a number to the console. Next, the Hello World component TS files defines an Angular component. This component contains a button that uses the writeCount function of the logger class. To access that function, the logger service is injected in the Hello World class by adding private logger logger to the constructor. Now, we just define a method which will call that function from the service and this method is connected with our button. And as you can see, on every button click, our method is being called. In this Angular introduction, we've discussed Angular, a client-side framework supporting multiple platforms. We covered some of its features and concepts. Hopefully, now you have a basic idea what Angular is and in what cases it may come handy.